Hello everyone and welcome to another painting tutorial. I decided to open a new topic on my channel by painting board games. I'm starting with the Descent. Because this board game has a lot of figures, I will paint about 10 figures per time. This means that there will be about 4 parts. Off camera, I spray painted almost all figures gray primer from a can. Now with Radom Tan, I apply base coat mostly to the cloaks. Radom Tan is a great color to base coat bright clothes.
Next base color, Alien Purple.
I'm going to paint this board game on tabletop quality. This means that there will be not many details, as we mostly focus on speed paint. Also, I tried to make this video as small as possible. To do so, I cut it a lot of scenes. So don't hesitate it if you see one figure in one scene unpainted and then 2 steps further. If I show you step by step all the painting process, I will end up with a 10-hour video. Also, don't hesitate for my terrible, terrible English.
Bloody Red. For the bluish base coat, we use ultramarine blue. Sick green for the greens. Earth mostly to the leathers. I used Sorby Gray to give a stone texture. Now it's time to apply shadows. I started by using Dark Flesstone against the Radom Tan. This is a very nice combination and I totally recommended it. Next, I apply mahogany to create shadows on the reds. I continue with Insignia Blue. For the shadows, I dilute the paint about 1:1 and I use about 15 to 20 psi on the airbrush. Next comes the dark green for the greens. When I apply shadows, I prefer to choose about 2 to 3 tones darker than the base coat, but no more than that. I applied Hexed Lichen to the last shadows. Now it's time for the highlights. As before, I prefer when I highlight to use 2 to 3 tones lighter this time than the base coat. Here I used Alien Purple and Den White at mix 1 to 3. We can't highlight red with lighter red, because lighter red is pink. For that, we are going to highlight with fire orange. When I find the opportunity, I use my favorite color, dark egg green. I used electric blue to highlight the blues. Don't worry if you overdone it with highlights. Washes will normalize them. To base coat the flesh, I used tan and pale flesh. I used the same colors as well to the hands and to the bodies. I used salt brown mostly to all the wooden parts. I base coat with chainmail silver, the swords, the plated armors, and some helmets. To the rest of the metal parts, I used polished gold. I applied magic blue to all the magic spheres. I applied my favorite sepia wash to random tens, to flashes and to the gold parts. With sky blue we make this sphere, magic sphere. With silver I dry brushed all the metallic parts. With silver we can also highlight the golden parts, as the highlights are more likely the same. The final stage is to paint the eyes. I used dead white and then black. And time to see the painting models. I know this tutorial was not very detailed, but don't forget we are talking about a board game with 40 figures and tabletop quality. This was the first part with the 21 figures, and of course soon I will upload the next part. So that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed it. You can always comment, like, subscribe and all this stuff. And I hope to see you in the next video. Bye!